Hey YouTube, what's up? Blue Witch here. So we're going to be doing a curse right now. Knifing that second. Alright. So this is a special curse because it is going to be requiring, it's a breakup curse, but it's also, I want to destroy them. And everything in their lives needs to be destroyed. They need to be dismantled. So we are cursing them and everything in their lives. Okay? And that's what this is. So I'm not going to be talking a whole lot during this because I'm just going to get this done. And I'm having a lot of really heavy, hot energy on me. It's very uncomfortable. And that's all, that's curse night, you know? But it's fine. So we're gonna start with the man. As you can see, I've done the petition already of everything that I want. I'm pulling up his picture and his petition, and then I'm going to be binding him to this chicken foot. I curse your dick. I curse your means of financial prosperity. No more. I curse your relationship. I curse everything prosperous in your life. That you will only have doom and gloom for all eternity. I curse your health. I curse your life. I curse your finances. I curse your relationship with, I curse everything in your life that you will only have doom, and you will only have doom and gloom. You have nothing left. Nothing works. You're sick. It just started raining really hard. I curse you. You have nothing but hate, sickness, poverty, and you will be alone for the rest of your life. I curse you. With this knot, I seal your fate. With this knot, I curse you for all eternity. You will forever live in darkness and sickness and poverty, alone for all eternity. I curse you. On this paper is a sigil of Hecate's will, and I place that on Hecate's will. Going on to the girl. Thank you. This is your stomach. Let this stomach be your stomach, that you always have knots in here, that your stomach always fills as though you are being slain, that you will never conceive another child, that none of the women who work for you will ever conceive another child. I condemn you to this pain, I condemn you to this doom. Bind you to this misery, that you will forever be in pain, that you will forever feel the pain in your stomach, that you will always be sick and unhealthy, that you will no longer be able to run the business of selling prostitutes, that they come and they find you and they send you back to where you came, that you're not welcome in this country anymore because you're a criminal and you're disgusting, to be not able to bring any more children into this world. I curse your stomach, I curse your woman parts, and I command that you be in poverty and in sickness and in pain for all eternity, that you never have peace again, that you're always doomed and live in sorrow and pain and suffering for all of your days. I curse you, Simodi. I curse you. I seal your fate. I curse you for all eternity. I curse your relationship, that he leave you. You, and he'll never ever be with you again, or any other woman for that matter, that he is cursed and you are cursed separately. You're not together anymore. You hate each other. You leave each other. You want nothing to do with any longer. You are in misery and suffering for all eternity. They are no longer bringing children into this world to be used as pawns. They are cursed. That financially they are cursed. They are cursed. They are cursed. They are cursed. I commanded that they will no longer be here. They are sick. They are always sick. Never feel good, always in pain. They cannot have sex anymore. They cannot have children anymore. Everything of happiness be taken from them. They be bound and gagged, and no longer allowed to break up any families. So more it be. So more it be. Disgust. hate. I curse you with hatred. I curse you with poverty. I curse you with sickness. I curse you with sickness. I curse you with hatred. I curse you with poverty. I curse you with loneliness. But you will both forever be lonely. You will never find comfort again. Love, that you will never have wealth, that you will live in poverty and sickness and loneliness and sorrow for all of eternity, that you will forever be sick and sorrow will follow you everywhere you go, that you will never have peace, that you will never have love, that you will always be sick and you will always live in sorrow. No poverty or no always live in poverty. You will have no financial blessings. You are cursed. You are cursed. You're separated. You're not going to be together ever again with anyone. You will always be alone. Your hearts will be filled with hatred. You will not be able to have any more children from any of your girls or from yourself. But you will always be alone. And you will always be. It was sin back to where you came. Poverty, poverty, poverty. I curse you with poverty. But you will always be poor. But you will always be sick and sorrowful. I seal your fate. As I tie this knot, I seal your fate. As I tie this knot, I seal your fate. As I tie this knot, I curse your relationships. As I tie this knot, I curse your relationships. As I tie this knot, I curse your relationships. Never find happiness. You will always be in poverty. You will always be in sickness. Everywhere you turn, everywhere you go, you are cursed. You will no longer do trafficking. That you will no longer traffic women from your very own country from which you come. That you will be sent back and that you will be dealt with by the laws of the land that you come from. which will probably be cutting your head chopped off. I send you back to where you came in sickness and poverty and sorrow, that you will feel the shame, that you will feel all of the pain that you have caused the families, that you will feel all of the sorrow and sickness that you have inflicted on the other women that you are trafficking. I curse you. I curse you. I curse you for all eternity. Forever, you are cursed in this realm and the next. I curse you with sickness. I curse you with poverty. I curse you with unhappiness and loneliness. You will never have another child from yourself or the women that you are trafficking. I command that you be stopped, that you be caught, and that you be sent back to the country where you came with your crimes known to the authorities. With your crimes known to the authorities, that you will be punished, that you will pay your dues, that you will be tortured in pain and sorrow and disgust and sickness. I curse you. I curse you. You are an accomplice, and that you too be punished by the law, that you can be brought to justice for what you're doing, for what you've done, for what you've helped do, for what you've supported being done to all of those poor women, that you also be brought to the authorities, that you be exposed for the disgusting piece of crap man that you are. You have no honor. You will die in sickness, alone, in poverty, in sickness, alone, and in poverty. The EBA held accountable for being an accomplice situation. I curse you both, and that you be separated, and that you be broke up, that you be separated and never be allowed to see each other ever again. To live in hatred and sorrow. You're disgusting, nasty. Curse you. I curse you. I curse you. Okay, you guys, this is the only one I'm going to be doing tonight because it's so dark and so heavy on me that I can't do another one. I can only do this one tonight. It's just really strong negative energy and it doesn't feel good. It feels really like cringy and achy and hard and just heavy on me. Which is, it's fine. It needed to be done. This is a necessary curse. This curse needed to be done. No one else has been able to do it. So I'm doing it. These people need to be held accountable for the horrible, horrible things that they're doing to people who are coming into our country, thinking that they're getting refuge and they're being trafficked out instead. Okay, guys, that's it for tonight. I'm going to be at the working altar with this bad boy for about 20 minutes. Tomorrow we're going to be doing a candle reading. I'll show you guys. I've shown you before, but I'll show you again. Starting to read again. Anyways, to see if someone else, if a young lady's been cursed or not, we're gonna do a candle reading and find out. And then my other curse that I was going to do tonight, along with this one, I won't be doing it until Tuesday. Because this one's just a lot. It's a lot. It's too much. I mean, I can handle it, but if I push it, I'll be sleeping for the next 3 days. Alright, guys, I am going to get off of here, go put this on the working altar. Oh, and I wanted to apologize to one of the. I did an unblocking yesterday, and for whatever reason, YouTube would not let me post it. I tried to post it like 4 times, and they wouldn't. They kept telling me that I couldn't. That it's been banned. I couldn't post it. So then I tried to like break it up, and then send it to you. I thought I'd just break it up and send it to you, you know, privately. And it wouldn't let me do that either. And then I ended up losing the whole thing. So I'm just taking it that it wasn't meant to be, that you weren't supposed to see it for whatever reason. I don't even remember all the things I talked about on that. And I don't remember, like, I just have no idea But anyway, so whatever we did in that video, it was not supposed to be shown for whatever reason. It was blocked and it wasn't allowed. And so I apologize for that. I assume that you got the pictures though. I did send pictures. And it's still burning. It's doing good. And then, yeah, it's doing great. And then, yeah, everything's going well. So far, so good on on everything. All the love spells went really good. I'm probably going to be taking most of them out, with the exception of the ones I just did last night. Those ones will remain with me until next week, but the rest of them will be going out to be buried, and as well as the curses. I have curses still on my altar that have been there for a while now. And they're all done. They're just sitting there though, so I gotta get on the ball and get all this stuff disposed of properly. This will be buried in a couple of days. I'm gonna keep on it. I'm just gonna put some dark crystals around it. It'll probably sit I'll have it right next to Belial's altar. I'll put a fresh candle on it every day for probably like 5 to 7 days. And then it will go out and be buried. Not here. It'll be buried like this one will probably have to go to the crossroads. Because I used Hecate's sigils. I used both the pentagram and the moons, and I used her will also. And because I used all of her sigils and stuff on this curse, I will probably be bearing this one out the crossroads. Normally like to stick them in the fire anthill, and they're everywhere, but yeah, it'll probably go at the crossroads. Than likely. So, okay, you guys, that's it for tonight. So, peace out, and I will be talking to you tomorrow for the candle reading. Okay, have a great weekend, you guys. Bye.